Manish, if you ask most fans about Adam Gase, the first thing they say is no, thank you. Is he a serious candidate for this job?
Yeah, he is. And quite frankly, he should be. If you look at what the Dolphins did, now he made the playoffs his first year. I think his biggest fault, if you want to say that, is his public backing of Ryan Tannehill. He was with Tannehill until almost the very end when it became apparent that Tannehill's probably not the future for that team. A lot of the stuff that has been reported in the last, week and a half about him losing the locker room, I did some research on that. I think that's overblown, based on people that I trust. I think a lot of that stuff is overblown. I think there's some erroneous reporting. There's some good reporters down there that I have a lot of respect for. So I'm not saying all the reporting was a little bit off base. I think there was some that was, I think there was some that was just that was not accurate. And if you look at the last 2 years specifically, last year he had Jay Cutler. Who's going to win with Jay Cutler? The guy came off his couch, right? Or off, he was doing TV or whatever he was doing before. They called him in for an emergency after Tannehill got hurt. So you almost have to write that off. This year, 11 games with Ryan Tannehill, 5 games, I believe, with Brock Osweiler. I don't want to say nobody could win with those guys, but, almost everybody would fail with those guys. And I don't want to make an excuse for Adam Gase because the record is what the record is. He has a strong personality. There's no denying that. I personally like that. Did he rub some players the wrong way? Yes. I think the most notable would be Jarvis Landry. But what I like about him and what was lacking from Todd Bowles is that he had an understanding of what players fit in his scheme. He has an understanding of what type of people fit in his building. Some of the issues with Bowles, and I like Bowles a lot, but some of the issues with Bowles were, he would identify a player and say, yeah, you know what, this guy fits. This guy fits with what we want to do. A month goes by, 6 weeks go by, it's not going to work. Let's get somebody else. That's not how you win a winning organization. Your coach has to know his personnel. He has to know what kind of personnel he wants. He needs to identify that properly and then coach the hell out of him and maximize that person's skill set. You cannot repeatedly say, yeah, I'm on board with this guy. I want this guy. I want that guy. Sign this guy. Draft this guy. And then after a month, after 2 months, give up on the guy. That puts everybody else in the organization in a precarious position. And no matter what anybody else tells you, that was the reality of the New York Jets over the last 3 years. Was Mike Maccagnan blameless? Of course he wasn't blameless. He made some terrible draft picks on his own. He made draft picks that didn't turn out well because he was bending over backwards for his coaching staff. I would argue that that's partly on Maccagnan as well because, again, he has control of the 53-man roster. I think he can be a little bit more, I think he can be a little bit more of a prick and say, hey, you know what? I'm in control of the 53-man roster. I know you guys like this player. I don't believe in this player, so I'm not drafting him. That's not his personality. I think that needs to change, quite frankly, moving forward, or he's never going to succeed as a general manager. So he was partly at fault. But as a head coach, you need to know which personnel makes sense for your team and for your scheme, and you can't constantly just jump ship and say, it's not working out, let's bring somebody else in. That's how teams get stuck in a rut. That's how teams become losing organizations. You never get off the ground if you don't understand what personnel makes sense. And I can say this about Gase. He did not like Jay Ajayi. He traded him to Philadelphia. Didn't want any parts of Jarvis Landry, let him get out of the building. Does that rub players the wrong way? Of course it rubs players the wrong way. So you can spin a narrative any way and say, well, this guy doesn't get along with players. Or you can look at it like this guy doesn't fit the culture that he is trying to build, so he got rid of them. Bill Belichick does it all the time. Is there backlash, on Belichick? Not as much as there would be on Adam Gase, because Belichick obviously has the clout and he's got the Super Bowl rings, but I like that mindset. I like the mindset of knowing what kind of players you want in that building and saying, hey, if you're not going to conform, you're out of here. Todd Bowles, as great of a guy as he is, he let guys get away with a lot of stuff. He really did. All fans saw was the end result of two notable disciplinary measures. Most recently, Trumaine Johnson being inactive for the season finale, and then last year, not sending Mo Wilkerson to New Orleans for his unprofessional, repeated repeated tardiness. It got to the point, not just Wilkerson, but you know, other people as well that, you know, whose names haven't surfaced. It got to the point where people were kind of getting away with murder. Todd Bowles let it slide, and this is what I said about Todd Bowles when he first got here. It's one of the most admirable things, I think, for him as a person, but not necessarily as a football coach, is that he treated everybody like adults. Now, he was a very mature player when he played for the Redskins. He's obviously a very mature head coach, level-headed guy. I think he treated everybody as adults. Unfortunately, not everybody, regardless of what it says on their birth certificate, is an adult in that locker room. And you got to treat people a little bit more heavy-handed. And that's something that Todd Bowles, if he ever does get an opportunity down the road to be head coach again, I think that's something he's going to need to correct.